Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Rosa. Welcome. I post beauty videos once a week on Mondays at 8 a.m. Pacific time, where I like to target mostly for light olive skin people like me. So if that sounds interesting to you, check out my channel and hang around by clicking on the subscribe button and don't forget the bell notification so that you can be notified every time I upload a video. Today's video is in collaboration with my friend Jaira. Her YouTube channel is called Olive Embrace. Thank you so much, Jaira, for reaching out to me and bringing this idea for us to do. We're both going to be bringing you 5 concealers that we recommend for olive skin. The only difference between us is that I'm going to be recommending the concealers for light olive skin while she will be recommending for medium olive skin. I try to stick to mostly drugstore prices, and my channel, if you don't know this about me, I try to stick to also cruelty-free. But for sure, when you're done watching my video, please head over to her video, and I will be linking that either up in the cards and down below in the description box. And without further ado, let's get into the video. This was quite the journey for me. I like to personally shop on Ulta. I just feel like they're very versatile when it comes to not only in their products, but like they have all kinds of brands, all kinds of prices, and all kinds of beauty related things. So I headed down to my local Ulta and I went shopping for concealers. Now, you gotta keep in mind, it's been hard because in this situation that we've been stuck for over a year now, that we are not able to swatch any products on site anymore. You kind of have to guess when you're looking at the product right in front of you. Sometimes when you're looking at a product, the color might not be the same thing when you swatch it, especially if that product oxidizes. So I went one afternoon and I ended up buying like 20 concealers. But unfortunately, most of them I had to return. Here are all the concealers that I have in my collection. A normal person does not need this many. I was trying to do my best not to return all of them just because I feel horrible returning products. Even though it's not illegal to do, Ulta does let you return products. I rarely return products. I really try to make them work. So that's why I have these concealers here. One way or another, these did not make it to the top 5 that I'm going to be showing you right now. These are in no specific order, so I'm just gonna pick up one and show it to you. Concealer number 1 that I recommend for you is the LA Girl Pro Concealer. Old school YouTube where I have to put my hand on the back of it so that the camera can focus. I hear that this one is an oldie but a goodie. I have never tried this one before until this year. So first of all, this is in the color GC958 Bisque. This retails for $4.99. for 0.28 ounces. The description for this one claims that it's a crease resistant with an opaque coverage, yet lightweight in texture, and I do have to agree with that. This one feels very light, and I almost feel like I don't have to set this with a powder, which is very rare for my creasy under eyes. It says it's a long-wearing formula that does camouflage darkness, redness, and skin imperfections, and I do also have to agree with that. I will be inserting a demo where I am covering my right under eye circles and some acne spots, and also I will be showing you how it looks in front of my vanity, which has like white lights versus natural light. I will also insert 2 pictures where you can see those differences. When I first swatch it, it doesn't seem like it has a very obvious olive undertone, but to my surprise, when putting it on my skin, it actually did a very good job at like blending into my skin. So this one has been a wonderful concealer. I would definitely go back to this. The second concealer that I recommend to you is the Catrice Liquid Camouflage High Coverage Concealer. This one is in the shade 020 Light Beige. I love that it only retails for $6 for 0.17 ounces. This was the first concealer that I fell in love with, and I have bought multiple ones of this. This one has been my go-to whenever I don't want to wear foundation. It is high pigmented and it's waterproof. This one does have a doe foot applicator, and as you will see in the demo, the coverage of this is pretty intense. It does cover up everything from dark circles to, you know, acne spots. And I do have to agree that this is extremely long wear and waterproof. The only strange thing about Catrice is that for some reason I haven't been able to find the exact same shade under HD Liquid Foundation. This one also has like a very lightweight application compared to like the Catrice Camouflage Cream, which I also love to use. Every once in a while I do use it for my face, but I mostly use it as an eyeshadow base. The only bad thing about this is that it is pretty scented, so if you're not into that, you might have a hard time with this one. Concealer number 3 is the newest concealer that I have tried, and this is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Full Coverage Concealer. This one also has a Delphi applicator. This shade I have is C5.7. This one retails for $7 for 0.11 ounces. It does have 4 out of 5 stars. And this one does have a true olive undertone. It matches my skin perfectly. Compared to the Catrice concealer, this one is not really scented. I do agree that this one is definitely full coverage, but it is also on the drier side. So this one, not so great underneath my eyes, but it's been great covering my acne spots. You will see in the demo as well how it applies under my white lights versus natural light. I'm really happy to have found a concealer that just matches me perfectly. The fourth concealer I want to recommend to you is the Kolab Makeup No Floss Liquid Concealer. This one retails for $12.99, and I got this at a Sally's Beauty store. I have the shade Sand/Beige. This one is a buildable medium to full coverage, but it leaves you with a natural luminous finish. It does feel very creamy, smooth, lightweight. I have quickly fallen in love with this one, and I've been really happy to use this not only for under eyes but like my face in general whenever I'm skipping the foundation. You will see in the demo using my finger as I did with the rest of the concealers, but it does very well using it with a brush and a beauty sponge, and I feel like I only need to set it very lightly with some translucent powder. So if you can get your hands on this one, I totally recommend it. Last but not least is the fifth concealer that I want to recommend to you, and this one is on the higher end of the price. This one is the It Bye Bye Under Eye Full Coverage Anti-Aging Waterproof Concealer. I have the shade 12.0 Light Sand W. This one retails for $28 for 0.4 ounces. This one is extreme coverage. You only need a tiny bit of this. It is very tacky, so I personally feel like I do have to set it. I would say that it is pretty water resistant, not completely waterproof, and it does last a pretty long time as well. You will see the demo as well for this concealer. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you will know that I have been using this concealer for over a year now. It's definitely one of my favorites. Because it has such a high coverage, I have not had the need to replace it. I'm still using it a year later. And of course, this wouldn't be a full video, in my opinion, without some swatches. So I'm gonna get closer and show you the swatches. Here are the swatches. So the first one is the LA Girl Pro Concealer. The second one is from Catrice. The third one, Makeup Revolution. The fourth one, Kolab. And the fifth one, It Cosmetics. As you can see, they do vary a little bit in color, but for some reason, they can still work. This one from Makeup Revolution would be my closest shade. Anyway, that's all I have for you guys. Please don't forget to check out Jaira's video. Let me know in the comments below, what is your favorite concealer? And don't forget to tell me what shade it is. I hope that you found this helpful, and if you did, please don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you haven't already, so that you can see more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on my next video. Bye!